A tale of two tours. Just like Kate's before her, Meghan's foreign debut has brought screaming fans, stolen moments and a lot of designer dresses. Meghan's first royal tour has so far brought screaming fans, stolen moments between her and new husband and a lot of designer dresses, just like Kate's foreign debut. The Duchess of Sussex, 37, has stepped out in over a dozen outfits so far in Australia, including looks by her own favorite designers such as Stella McCartney and Jason Wu, as well as looks from local brands. The Duchess of Cambridge, now 36, also had regular outfit changes on her first major tour of Canada back in 2011, sporting up to three different outfits in a single day, as Meghan did on Saturday. Meghan and Harry have been giving a typically tactile display while in Australia so far, following the news of their pregnancy at the start of their 16-day tour. Meanwhile, William and Kate, who had been married for just over 2 months, also gave rare PDAs when they embarked on their first overseas together, which lasted 11 days. Here, Female takes a look at some of the similarities and differences between the two duchesses' major overseas tours. Newlyweds in love. Harry and Meghan are known for their PDAs, and have unsurprisingly put on a tactile display following their pregnancy announcement at the start of the tour. The couple have been walking hand in hand during many of their official engagements, including a visit to the beach in Melbourne last week. But while Kate and William are known to be more reserved in this regard, the pair also put on an affectionate display as newlyweds during their first royal tour in Canada. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge were seen sharing a sweet embrace while competing on opposite sides in a dragon boat race while visiting Prince Edward Island. The loved-up newlyweds were also seen exchanging jokes at each other during the visit. Body language expert and author Judy James commented, "William and Kate looked competitive and playful on their first major tour. They were far more tactile than we see now, but the touching and cuddling was always presented as something fun and youthful." Speaking about Harry and Meghan's loving display, she continued, "Unlike Kate, Meghan will take a loving arm hold or touch and double it up by holding Harry with both hands to both keep him near and emphasize possession and attachment. Meghan's signals of adoration and support of her man are very open and emphatic." She continued, "Unlike William and Kate, Harry and Meghan have used plenty of eye-to-eye contact on this tour. As well as signaling love, there might be a very practical purpose for this." William and Kate had already known each other for several years before their tour. Harry and Meghan have known each other for a much shorter space of time and their lives have been very different. This means the intense eye contact will be about reading one another. The fashion. Meghan has worn over £11,000 worth of designer labels so far in Australia, including some of her favorite brands. She has also made sure to pay tribute to local designers, stepping out in dresses by Aussie designers Karen G, Martin Grant, and Dion Lee. Kate also picked out looks from some of her go-to labels, including Jenny Packham and Alexander McQueen, while opting for Canadian brands, including Smythe, and Montreal-born designer Dem, now one of her favorite designers. Celebrity stylist Rochelle White told Female has seen similarities between the pair's royal tour wardrobes, commenting, "Meghan and Kate have got similar taste when it comes to some looks, like the fitted dresses and casual trousers and jacket combo. They are good at mixing the brands they are loyal to and ones that they come across that could be new to them." Meghan has embraced fun outfits during the tour, putting on a floral lay with her striped dress while visiting Bondi Beach with Prince Harry. Meanwhile, Kate also got into the local spirit when she and William donned Stetson hats while in Calgary back in 2011. The Duchess of Sussex's off-duty look has been perhaps more daring than Kate's on her first royal tour, with Meghan opting for a £166,218, $305.91, dress by U.S. brand Reformation on Fraser Island on Monday, featuring a thigh-high split. Rochelle commented, "I love that Meghan has had a more relaxed feel when it comes to her fashion choices on her Australia trip. With her casual look, it's not something that you see many royals wearing, but I think it's great that Meghan is being bold and making these choices." Royal jewels. Meghan paid tribute to Princess Diana by wearing a pair of butterfly earrings and a gold bracelet that belonged Harry's late mother on the first day of her royal tour, in Sydney. The earrings were part of Diana's personal jewelry collection, but it is not known whether they were a gift or purchased herself. Kate also made a nod to the Princess of Wales during her first royal tour, wearing a pair of her sapphire earrings, which she has worn on a number of occasions. Meghan wore a pair of earrings given to her by the Queen, which she first wore during their joint engagement in Chester, while arriving in Fiji today. Meanwhile, the Duchess of Cambridge wore a maple leaf brooch belonging to the Queen during her first royal tour, which was first worn by the monarch on a trip to Canada in 1951. It was reported at the time that the Queen had given Kate the pick of her jewelry collection for the trip. Touching moments. The Duchess of Sussex has shown that she's a natural with children during her tour of Australia, with her and Harry bonding with 5-year-old Luke Vincent, who has Down syndrome, in Dubbo. Meghan, who is expecting her first child in the spring, also shared a sweet moment with 9-year-old Sethunya Gibbons, after she noted how much the youngster looked like herself. Meanwhile, the Duchess of Cambridge shared a sweet moment with young cancer sufferer Diamond Marshall, who gave her a warm hug while greeting the royal at Calgary Airport. Kate was said to have been saddened by the news that the youngster had died 3 years later, in 2014.